See, the basic idea of forming Kisan Ekta or bringing the farmer leaders together on one platform is that over the years you must have observed, and everyone must have observed this, that farmers are divided, are a divided lot. They are divided on the basis of political leanings, on political ideology, with economic ideology, or also on caste and ego considerations. Now, that is one reason why the farmer is locally a hero, but at the national level, if you see, they are a zero. You know, they are zero. And farmers do not appear anywhere in the economic radar screen of the country. The thinking over the years has been that because farmers are not organized, they are not united, that's the reason why the farmers are not talked about as far as economic policies are concerned. So the effort has been, many farmers organizations wanted me to take an initiative where I could bring people together onto one platform so that now we could forget our leanings or differences and come together as a unified force. And I think in a democracy, a unified force is what determines the eventual benefit that goes towards that section of the society. See, my understanding of when you talk of farming crisis is that roughly 40% of the farming population of the country comprises of the fisher folk. Now, fishermen are a very important part of the farming community. This is what is seen as officially, but normally farmers organizations do not interact with fishermen, and similarly fishermen would not be interacting with the farmers organization. But I invited the fishermen organization for the first time into the Kisan Ekta meeting because my understanding is that fishermen and farmers have to fight together. They have to come together to build up their voice. And this time at Shimla, the effort was to whatever we could, identify some groups, bring them into Shimla. Now this is the beginning. So in future, you will see more and more of a representation from fishermen folk also in Kisan Ekta. And I'm just thinking of expanding the scope of farmer movement in this country. If you look at MSP, there are number of issues which now tell us that the time for price policy has gone, and we are now moving into what is called as income policy. Now, this I think is something that the farmer leaders have to understand. Why? Because one, there is a pressure from World Trade Organization to see that the subsidies on agriculture through the MSP, minimum support price, are reduced drastically. So that means the World Trade Organization does not allow more subsidies or more MSP or more still higher MSP to be given. They also do not want more crops to be added to the procurement system, so which means it's limited now. And then we have seen that the pressure from internationally and nationally is, or maybe what you call as autonomous policies, are ensuring that the MSP has to be dismantled gradually. So you see in Chhattisgarh, they have reduced the quantity that you can procure from a farmer. They have also done away with the bonus opportunity that you could provide to the farmers. In Punjab and Haryana, where MSP has been a tradition, the pressure on the governments has been to dismantle MSPs and allow the markets to operate. So knowing all these things, there's a limited scope now for MSP to be expanded to other crops. Similarly, what is more important is to know, first of all, that only 6% farmers in India get the benefit of minimum support price. 94% farmers are already outside the ambit of MSP. So when we talk of going by Swaminathan committee report, which says 50% profit in addition to C2 cost, the cost of cultivation, then I think we are only addressing the issue of providing that profit to only 6% of the population or the farming community which takes the benefit of MSP. 94% are outside the ambit of it. So our understanding has been that this is not something which benefits all farmers. It benefits only a section of the farmers. So in this condition or situation, the best way is to go for what is called as you know, a guaranteed income for farmers, which would mean that, you know, there has to be commission which works out what can be the minimum assured income, a package that a farmer must get every month, depending upon what is the productivity he attains and also you know, what geographical location of the place that he is located at. Because the farms in Himachal Pradesh cannot be equated with the farms in Rajasthan, for that matter. So it has to be location specific. So that's what the idea is. And I'm glad that Farmer Income Commission demand that I raised about 8-10 years back is now being talked about at various platforms nationally. And I think this is something that is now getting into the mind of the government as one way of addressing this agrarian crisis. See, the operational modalities would be looked after by the commission itself. That is why we are suggesting that there should be income commission for farmers. But I think what is becoming difficult for farmers, or let's say it's not coming so easy for them to understand as to what the demand or what the income, guaranteed income, means for them, is basically because over the last few decades, you know, ever since Green Revolution came into this country, the farmers have got so tuned to MSP, MSP and MSP that they can't figure out anything beyond MSP. For them, their world ends with MSP, because if the MSP is raised, they think all problems of the farmers are addressed. And so it will take us some time to really make them understand, or them to understand, what exactly is the bigger connotation of MSP vis-a-vis the Farmers Income Commission that we are talking. But I think what is equally more important is that these farmer leaders, since they have not been exposed, and I don't blame them, because if I remember when I first started talking about the Farmers Income Commission and a need for a guaranteed income price, the initial opposition or questioning was from the farmer leaders themselves. They would ask, where will the money come from? You know, I have never seen government employees asking the finance minister or asking themselves, where will the money come from for the seventh pay commission? Nobody is asking that. And so I think farmers have been, because they've been made to believe as if, you know, there is a very, you know, there's no money for them in the country. So they have to live within their means and so on and so forth. So that is why they got tuned to it. And now I think for them to come out of that, it will take some time. But eventually, wherever I go in the country, I find there's a tremendous, tremendous response to the, when I talk about Farmers Income Commission. And I think that is now catching up. So I'm sure gradually, when these farmers start asking their own leaders, things would change. We do not know what will be the roadmap. Let me be honest with you. We are just trying to explore the possibility that considering that 2019 elections are, of course, going to be faced with all of us, by all of us. My idea of thinking is that farmers over the years have been treated only for two purposes. You know, they're either the vote bank or they have been treated as a land bank. Now is the time that their role should move beyond vote bank and land bank, where they are not the ones who are being played around for you know, deciding where to vote. But I think what more important should be that now the political parties should be looking at what the farmers want them to do, how and what they want them to deliver. I think that is what I mean by saying, when I say that in 2019, how can we influence the political thinking at that particular time? So it is a long call, I would say. At the same time, it requires a lot of strategical and planning and so on to go into it. I think this Shimla convention from 18th to 20th June, we have initiated this process, and it will take us some time more to come to grips as to how we can really prepare ourselves to influence in a manner that the political parties at that time talk about farmers as if it's a priority agenda for the country. They just don't relegate it to the bottom of the pit. That is what we have been treated so far. And I think it's time now the farmers raise their voice. Because after all, if 60 crore farmers wake up in this country, then I think it should be farmers who will be ruling the country, nobody else. Then, so why not? If we are the biggest majority in the country, then I think we should have a bigger say.